Hello, welcome back to another video here at Meggy Move Creations. So today I'm going to be creating an earring slab and we're going to be making some earrings. They're going to be kind of on the bigger side because I want them to be little scenes with crabs because I made this to make a crab charm. It's like translucent clay and red clay. And I don't really want to waste it, so I'm just going to go ahead and roll out my white clay. So, what I'm going to do... just make sure that everything is all good. I'm gonna chop off some of this excess. Don't want too much to come off, but some of this is uneven, so the more we can get off, the better it will be, basically. So if I remove that, we've got some, no, we've got enough here to create the pair of earrings that I want to create. So, let me take my pieces. I'm just gonna make a note of where I want them, sort of give myself a guide as to where these can go. Okay. Those overlap a bit. I may have to roll out another bit. Or I could just turn it over. So resourceful. Okay. Well, now I can see where they are. Here is what I'm working with. So it's time to take some of this red and create some little scenes with some little crabs on them. I used to make these all the time when I was first starting out clay. It was like a little weird obsession that I had. So yeah, we've come a long way since then. But sometimes it's good to just revert to your roots. So what I'm gonna do is cut some pieces from here, and then I'm just gonna sort of smush them down a bit and put a line down the middle. I'm just creating some seaweed. Just going to repeat that for both greens. I'm just creating some seaweed. It's really cool. I remember doing this so much. I'm so glad that I stopped. Otherwise, I would have just created crabs forever. Okay. gonna take some of this granite clay now. I'm gonna kind of build up some rocks at the bottom. That's one done. Let's see what we can do with the other. So I think I might make a stubby bit of seaweed for either side. Right then, now that we've kind of got a bit of a base going on, I think it's about time that I start making this crab. Well, the two crabs that are going to go on each earring. Now I've made the body, so now it's time to cut small pieces for the legs. So, kind of these bits. Three legs, got it right up. Okay, now to make some pincers. One pincer is always bigger than the other. Did you know that? But you didn't. No. Although these pincers seem to be massive, so who knows? It seems to be a bit more of a normal size pincer, so let's cut that down a bit. Okay. Let's make two. Okay, cool. So now I want to make some little eyes and a little crabby frame. So I'm going to take the black. I did have some black somewhere. Dropped it. So here are our little crabbies, and then pop them on the little rocks. Okay. So now what I want to do is take some pastel blue as well as maybe any other blue. I have like this peppermint colour. I think that might actually work nice, or in conjunction with, I'm not sure yet. But this isn't quite dark blue, but it's not quite turquoise either. But I was thinking I would make some bubbles with them. Kind of just pop them down. The big ones I want to go at the top, and then I'm going to create some smaller ones for the actual one. That's what I'm trying to say. So let's make some smaller bubbles now. have our crab earrings. Oh dear. Okay, let's see what we're doing then. Gonna have to take a little bit off there. Okay, cool. And put in I want to bake it on this tile, so I'm going to leave those there, and I am just going to move over to here. I think for these, all I'm really going to do is create some seaweed, maybe a few rocks, and put in some bubbles rather than trying to flap around too much. Okay, so let's find some granite clay, give that a roll out. Cut off some little pieces. And then get some of this peppermint clay again, cut off two pieces for the bubbles, and I'm just gonna fit them on there. Okay, and that's it. So now is time for me to bake these, and once they are baked, I'll come back and show you how I fix them together and show you what they look like once they are fully finished. So let me bake them and I'll see you later.